left on here. Well, I got me a new toy to play with, and I hope. Hang on, I'm all out of sorts here. Gotta get those socks just right. When they start falling down, they bug me. Okay, so this is my mic stand here. I have it mounted to my rack that the camera is sitting on right now. Filming with one of these phones, the Alcatel A45. This is my Shure SM58 on the stand that I use for my desktop videos and stuff. It's Shure SM58 microphone, if you don't know what that is. What I've got here is, it's not plugged into anything right now. And here is the cable. I'm getting tangled up here. Here's the cable that I normally use. I have it plugged into, I have it running through my cassette deck. Actually this cassette deck, it's a TAC, it's a good cassette deck, but it's a newer one from, well, about 10 or 15 years ago. Bought it brand new. It's behind the phone up there, on the rack. And I keep thinking I'm talking into the mic. I keep forgetting I don't even have it plugged in yet. But what I'm using here, I used to do sound for bands, and I have some pro audio cables and stuff still. Pro audio cables. And anyway, this is what's called an insert cable. It's a TRS tip ring sleeve connector on one end, and the other end, well, there's several different ones. This is not actually an insert cable. It has RCAs on the other end. An insert cable would have just quarter inch, or what you would call mono plugs on the other end. And I won't go into what you normally use an insert cable for, but this is that type of cable, but it has RCAs and on the other end, and so it plugs right into the back of my cassette deck to the input. If it had a mic input, that would be perfect, but it doesn't. I have my old original 1970s TAC out in the garage somewhere, and I still haven't been able to dig it out. It's in some boxes somewhere. And I used to use it for a preamp for my guitar, for my mics. It worked perfectly because it has a mic input. And you have adjustable gain. Of course, you have that in these two. You have the recording levels, is what it is, on this one. Only thing is, it's not made for a mic, so it's a pretty weak signal. It doesn't have the preamplification that the other one did and does. The other one got old, and the tape, you know, it's the motor. Actually, really, all I think went wrong with it was the belt wore out in the motor. You know, the tapes played at the wrong speed, and I never did find another belt for it. But eventually, this was back in the 80s when it quit working, early 90s when it quit working right. And in the late 90s, I ended up buying, or early 2000s, I ended up buying this TAC because I really liked my original one. It's a dual cassette deck, and it'll do copying and all that stuff. Of course, cassettes are considered ancient now, and I don't use them much, but I use the deck all the time for my preamp, for my microphone. And so this is the one going into, this is the cable that goes into the cassette deck. Let me think about how that goes. Okay, this is the cable coming out of the cassette deck, going into my recording device, my computer, you know, is what I'm always using, to record audio into. When I want to do my desktop videos and stuff, it works out really well. And since I've got these phones, the one problem I have is what, unless I edit this video, you will experience right now. I'm about 3 feet, or maybe, yeah, about 3 to 4, 3.5 feet from the phone that's doing the recording, the video, and my voice is too low. There's no setting, no adjustment for the audio input. It's automatic, and it's really just kind of one level. It doesn't change from what I can tell from all the videos I had. Sorry, I'm burping my ham and beans and cornbread I had for dinner tonight, or lunch, or whatever. I got up late. That's my coffee. It's Christmas Day, our evening night, 2016, and that's what we had today. So, anyway, I got this cable. Long story, even longer. I saw an article on hackaday.com that was talking about different things you could use. This is in my way. I don't know why I have it there right this moment. Okay. So, I already had this audio USB audio adapter that I got from my computer. I originally got it for a laptop that I blew out the audio input chip on. And it'll work on any computer. It'll work in Windows and Linux. I don't know. I don't have any Macs, so I don't know about that. I got this all plugged up. I can't really explain it. Anyway, it's a pretty good little. It's an audio input and output, so pretty handy. Use them sometimes. I ended up getting two of them because they were only $2. And I bought this adapter cable for the phone. And this is these are Android phones. And what it does, now this is my charging cable. I'm just going to leave it. It's hard to plug and unplug it. It's already plugged in here. My charging cable going down to the charger, plugged into the AC outlet. So that sends power to your phone. Now you can plug in devices. You know, I'm plugging this. I'm going to try the audio adapter and see if it'll work on the phone because, I read that article saying that you could get that to work on your phone. You can get those to work on your phone. Here is a SD card and a USB adapter that you could plug in there. I haven't even tried it yet, but it should work. That should work perfectly without any, you know, just plug and go. It should. So anyway, what I want to do first, that's what I got it for. I want to plug this into my phone, and I want to plug the. I want to do my microphone. I want to do my audio input. I got to make sure I get the right one. This one's nice. It's marked. You got a picture of headphones and a picture of a mic on the end there, so you don't have to remember what colors. They're always changing. There's no such thing as a color code. If you thought there was, there's not, because people don't go by it. So there's really no such thing. People don't go by it. So everybody makes up their own. All the different manufacturers and house wiring, especially. People think there's color codes in house wiring. Well, there's not. Not in practicality. So I got it plugged in here. There it is. Of course, you're not going to be able to carry this around and go anywhere with it. I mean, you could strap it on your belt or something. Of course, it'd come off as soon as you moved around. But well, it's not falling apart. But it's not a mobile setup. It's for sale. It's only if it works. And I think it will. But if it works, it's only going to work. And of course, it's plugged into the charger because I didn't want my phone to run down. Running the video runs down the battery of my phone's in about 10 minutes. I think I get around 20 minutes out of it. Runs down my battery. So now here's I'm normally not moving my hands around a lot whenever I'm doing a desktop video. I'm usually just working the computer. This is how I have my setup. It's the best way I could set it up. But I have to get it just right so that I can still type. I don't know if you can see. I think you can see the keyboard. And then if I want to move this hand, I have to be careful and go around. Sometimes I forget and bang into the microphone. But I'm not making a desktop video now anyway. I have three of these phones. These identical Alcatel A45L phones here. So I'm going to get this one up and going. And I'm going to go ahead and plug it in. Not really going to be able to show, I don't think, much of what I'm doing here. I mean, I can try to put the, I don't, even if I put it, this is so small, I can barely see it. I think the phone may be going to sleep too quick. My menus are going away quicker than I can use them. Let me see, let me look, check my display. Sometimes it changes itself. Yep. I set it on go to sleep after 15, 1 minute, and it always constantly sets itself back to 15 seconds, and that's not, you can't even use the phone that way. Okay, so I pull this little bar down from the top, and I can see what's being done on the phone, so I'm going to plug this in, see if it recognizes my device. Now, it hasn't recognized anything. I don't know if that's normal or not. I have it all plugged in. And It's my first time to try it, so I don't know what's typical here. You know, maybe this audio device of mine may not be recognized by the phone. I don't know yet. I'm fixing to find out. I'm gonna get this in some way to where I can. But it didn't. It just nothing came up. It didn't say USB device recognized or anything. I'm gonna go ahead and open up my camera app and see if it's one of the go into the setup and see, because you can select different this is open camera, by the way. It's not one of those standard apps that comes with the phone. You wouldn't be, I don't know if you'd be able to do it with one of those. But I'm gonna go into the setup and see if I can. There we go, audio source. Okay, now it's defaults to, it has camcorder, external mic if present, default audio source, optimized for voice. And I had got to using optimized for voice because it did seem to be better as far as, you know, just using the phone like I am right now. But I always thought, well, if I had a USB mic, you know, I might could, what I'd really like to have. Actually, I tried this and it worked. I think it automatically found it. I have where is it? Well, anyway, you know what a Bluetooth headset looks like. It's right there somewhere. And it worked, and I could record that way. But the problem with that is it's an old one somebody gave me, and the battery's down. Well, I mean, it's dead, and the batteries, they're not really made to change the batteries. I saw some articles and YouTube videos on them that you could do it. You got to solder it, a new one back, you know, get one and solder it in there and all that stuff. But they're about $7. I don't know if that was, I think that was worth free shipping on Amazon. I think I found one. But, you know, you can buy them for $12 or $25. So I didn't know if I wanted, I don't know if I wanted to do that. But anyway, okay, so I'm in my screen here, and all these wires, I can't really turn this phone around, so I'm not going to try to turn it around. I'm going to change it to external mic if present. Now, I'll just see if it works. Let's see. I like this open camera app. There's only one thing about it I don't like, and that is when you set up your custom settings, sometimes after it'll work perfectly and then it'll crash. I think every time they updated it crashes is what it seems to me, but yeah, see, of course this is a really an unruly mess to try to work with. I mean, you know, this stuff here weighs more than the phone does. This whole adapter setup. But let me turn it on and see if my mic's picking up. I'll go ahead and set my, I always want to set, autofocus won't stay on, I gotta turn it on every time. And that dangling could be bad on your USB plug on your phone. Hey, Don here. Okay, so I'm testing using an external mic on open camera on my Alcatel 845L. Of course, moving your mic cable always makes noise, and I just did that. It's just dangling here. You can see in the tripod video that it's kind of a big mess. What I was wondering if there might be a feasible way to, yeah, this first thing I'm having trouble with, I just realized, if I move the camera, of course, if I was just using my phone camera on the tripod, then, you know, I could tape these to the legs of the tripod or something where they don't move. And of course, if you're using the tripod, there's the tripod in this video, then you're not planning on moving it, you know. So that could be usable. The only time the things I do, I'm usually wanting to do a handheld, you know, move the camera around. Now I'm moving my chair and I forgot about the mic. It's not too good for that. It's just really. And usually when I'm holding the camera in my hand, I just try to remember not to stick my finger in front of the lens. I'm doing that now because of the way I'm holding it, but keep it close enough that it gets a decent enough sound. But anyway, Let's see what if that worked. Okay. And unplug this thing from the phone because it is really unruly mess. It doesn't fall apart, at least. Now let me get in my VLC and see. Move this mic up here. It makes me think I'm supposed to talk on it. Okay. Sometimes either VLC didn't see the video yet, or there it is. It wasn't finished. I guess it had to. Wasn't quite finished rendering. I guess they do render on the fly, but they have to finish. And there it is. It worked. Cool. So if I want to do it, I want to stop that video now. So if I want to do that, I can. And all I had to do was change my setting. I mean, maybe it would have worked if I had to change the settings. I don't think it would, because I don't know. The phone might automatically pick up that mic if it's plugged in. But that is awesome. Ah, wait a minute. How do I know that was the mic and not the built-in mic on the phone? I don't. So I'll have to watch the video back, and I'll have to do some tests. Okay, let's do that again. Plug him back up. Maybe I should do it with the phone on the tripod. Yeah, I think I will. Let's plug this in. I'm going to stop the video over here. Do it with that phone that's on the tripod, because that way I can, and I'll probably just take this to the tripod. Well, first I want to see if it works at all. Okay, before I end this here video, let's make sure that I'm actually getting it from the mic. How will I know that? Well, I'll move the mic around a lot and find out. Okay, let's plug this in. And then open the camera app. Let's look at our settings, see if they're still where they were. Video settings. You go to video settings and then you go to audio source in this open camera app. It's still there where I left it, external mic if present. So if there wasn't a mic present, it would default back to the main mic, the built-in mic. So that's good. I mean, it will work either way. It's a good failsafe. But it didn't sound any different right off the bat there. Now you got to watch the. You really got to watch the settings in this this app. It will. The buttons will turn, they'll turn themselves off. Like the record audio is off. Okay, now it's on. It, me fooling around in there, it went off. See, before you get out of those settings, pay attention. You may be turning something off instead of setting it up. Okay, Don here. I am testing. This is my setup. It's my, little USB audio. I'm using my SM58 running through the cassette deck, the TX cassette deck, into this USB audio device. It's an input and output, and I've got it plugged into the mic side. I can see that there. I'm using my wires and adapters, and I'm making my another camera on the tripod over there. But let me, these cables are really aggravating to deal with. Okay, now I'm going to move my mic far away, or myself far away from the mic, and see. I'll keep talking and move around. Okay, I'm going to be talking. Test 1, 2, 3, test, 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 test. test, and moving my chair back and forth, test. Okay, now, let me move the mic way far away, see if it sound went away or if it stayed about the same. Now I'll get close to the phone. Test 1, 2, testing 1, 2, mic test, double check, triple check, quadruple check. And as much as now I'm back with the mic close to me, keep the phone a little further away. As much as I'm moving that cable, I'm sure I would be getting noise if it was coming through the mic too. So let's see what we got. Alright, now. One. Unplug that because it's just really crazy. You know, I'm used to having cameras that anything from your old VCR, you know, tape camera to had a professional Sony Betacam, a Sony BBP3 I got in about 97 or something like that. Had for several years. I got it at an auction for $350, and when it was brand new, it was a $10,000 camera. It was a real studio camera, TV camera. And that thing weighed, you know, about 45 pounds. So I'm used to stuff like that, not a phone. It is nice, I'm being light, but it's also, it's hard to remember, you know, they're so easy to move around, it's hard to remember to take it easy and don't make your shot all jumbly. And okay, now let's play back that last video. My introduction is too long. Okay, so the sound was coming through the phone mic on the phone. So you might have to get this to work. You might, I'm not sure what you could do. So this is just a long video that's not too good because you can't tell what I'm really doing. What I should do probably is set this phone up to be a desktop phone, desktop video, and then show, like I'm thinking, well, I could go into the settings and look, see if there's any, I don't really know of any audio settings in the phone software, you know, the operating system. I think it's all in the apps, but it didn't just by default find it. There are probably some apps that are for recording audio that, you know, might find the external mic. Of course, the only thing I made was interested in was the video. So I don't know, it may not even work. But and these do work without, you know, installing. Well, I don't, yeah, I've used them in Windows. The thing is with Linux, you don't it's so seamless. You don't have to. It may install some sort of Linux. They don't call them drivers, really. Everybody calls them drivers now, but when I first got into Linux in 2005, and for the first 5 years or so, you never saw anything on a Linux website saying the driver. They'd say Linux does not use drivers. It uses so-and-so, so-and-so. I've already forgot. I always forget the names of everything. It uses this, you know. So, but anyway, it was automatic and seamless. And, like, if, say, The closest thing to installing drivers, well, it actually does say that now, I think, in Fedora Linux. If you plug in a HP printer to Fedora Linux, it will say, you know, you'll get a little notice on your desktop, found the HP printer, do you want to install the, I don't know if it says the software or the drivers, it may just say software, but anyway, it'll do that, and it'll do it automatically. If it has any problems, it'll ask you, do you want this one or that one, and you pick the one, you know, the one that's your model, or the closest to your model. If, but usually, I just, with HPs, it's, you usually always find your model printer. But, now if you have a, for instance, I think an Epson, then you'll have to go download the drivers and install them, kind of like you do with Windows. But, particular Epson that we had, anyway, Epson printer. But, I mean, it wasn't in the repositories, you had to go find it on the Epson website, that's what I mean. But this thing, plugging into the phone, this is Android, and it's based, you know, Android's based on Linux, built on the Linux kernel, but it's not Linux, it's very different, so in a lot of ways. If you look in the operating system and the file structure, it's the same, but the ecosystem and the software setup is different. So, I've used it on a Windows system before and it worked fine. I believe it, and I didn't have to put a CD or it didn't come with it. You know, it's supposed to be plug and play, and not have to, you know, download drivers and stuff. And I never have had to. But on the phone, I don't know. I don't know what I'd be getting into. I'm not sure what I'd be getting into to. Try and make it work since it didn't work right off the bat. And of course, there could be other reasons. Here, let's try. Here's what I'll do next. Let's just make sure that the device seems to be working at all. This cable, I mean. Let's plug in my SD card. And I do remember reading on the reviews. They kept saying you couldn't charge your phone while you were using a device, but it looks to me like you could, because it, well, maybe it won't charge the phone. Oh, that's what they said. They said this power would power the device. That's why I went ahead and plugged it in. That thing might need some power, that audio adapter. This little SD card is not going to need hardly anything, you know. So let's plug it in. And anyway, yeah, so they were, a lot of people were wanting to be able to charge their phone while it's plugged in, and I still have the charger plugged in. My little, that's a little SD, 32 gigabyte SD card. Okay, it says it's charging, so it does charge while the SD card's plugged in. It came up saying charging. Yeah. Okay. Now let's see. I guess I'll go into Total. I like Total Commander. I have Total Commander on my phone, so go into Total Commander. Yes, I only see two cards. Yeah, it's only got my big SD card that's in there. And my, that's all I'm seeing. Now, let me try another file manager. See, I don't know what to, let me just go to storage, okay, on the system. Okay, my 64 gigabyte SD card and my onboard storage is there. It's not seeing it. Okay. So, I'm going to unplug it. And I'm going to unplug it from the charger. Maybe having it plugged into the charger causes it not to recognize what's in here. So now I'm going to plug it in. See if it does anything. Doesn't show anything new came into the phone. I may have to go in there and say mount it, you know, somewhere. Yeah, it still doesn't show anything. So that didn't make the difference. But I don't need that cable right now, so, and it's a lot easier to mess with the phone like this. Try Total Commander. I don't use Total Commander a lot on the phone. It, you know, it's a little harder to use on the phone because, okay, for one thing, everything's so tiny. But the other thing is, and I don't remember, it doesn't have words, it has symbols. And I don't remember what they mean. But I just like, I love it on the computer. Let me see what other app is there for. I know there's another one that's built into the system. And then there, oh, I know what I've got. Where's that? Only one toolbox will look at the files. File manager, yeah, it has a file manager. Okay. Two devices. I'm not seeing another device to mount. Let's go in here. I know that whenever I plugged in SD cards, other SD card, well, when I first got my SD cards, it's not seeing it. So, and this is an SD card in a USB adapter and a USB adapter for the phone here. Okay, so I guess I need to go back and do some homework and figure all this out. But yeah, if I was going to show, you know, I mean, just showing me holding the phone, I know I hate those videos where you can't see what's going on. So I won't keep doing that. I guess if I really wanted to show, I'd make a desktop, try to set up and make a desktop video of it. So anyway, since it's not working with either one, then the phone's just not recognizing anything through that adapter right now. And I think it would work unless there was something wrong with it. It charges the phone, so I doubt there's anything wrong with it. What I need to do is figure out how to mount that. Probably, I don't know which one would be easier, but figure out what it takes to make it recognize stuff, and then get back to you. All right, this is Don, and oh well, we tried.
Bye bye.